to address something that took place last week in connection to my son's father, Carl Crawford. And initially, I wasn't going to say anything. Initially, I wasn't going to comment because I feel like a lot of the times when there is something going on in Carl's world, my name tends to get thrown in anything that he has going on. So I understand, you know, that there are some people that are always going to connect us together because I'm his ex-fiance and we were together. But after my team got their second or third phone call in connection to what happened last week, the domestic violence arrest, I had to say something because I see stories popping up with, you know, people trying to change my story and my narrative. I've heard a reporter saying, oh, well, you know, can we get a comment from her? Didn't she say that Carl did the same to her? And I refuse to sit here and allow the world or anybody to change my story and my truth. So that's why I'm putting this video together. And let me just stress one thing. By no means am I trying to discredit anyone else's story. I know what that feels like. So that is not what I'm trying to do. I don't know what happened with the relationship before me. I don't know what happened with the relationship after me. I stay in my lane. I'm just talking about my personal experience because I was engaged to be married to this man. I was with him for 4 years. And for any blogger or reporter to try to switch up the story as to why we broke up, I think is disgusting, you know? And I have to protect my son. I never want my son to see, oh, okay, well, mom and dad, you know, I see a story that he did this to her. No, he did not. Carl has never put his hands on me. Carl has never intimidated me. Carl has never called me bitches and hoes or ever stood over me trying to intimidate me. We never had that relationship. Yeah, we broke up for other reasons, but it wasn't for that. And that's why I'm doing things. And I also want to say for anyone that is dealing with domestic violence, you guys know I take this very, very seriously. For anyone that is dealing with domestic violence, if you know somebody that is dealing with domestic violence, you could go to evelynlozada.org. I have people on my staff that will answer emails, talk to you. We can give you advice, you know, point you in the best direction as to how to get out of this relationship. I'm here for you, you know, but I just really, really felt like I needed to, you know, address this. I didn't want this to continue to snowball into something that is not true. I'm just speaking from my heart. I'm just speaking about my truth in connection to my son's father. And that's it. You know, I've never had that situation happen to me. And we are cool to this day. And all I care about is that we co-parent our son and that he's able to co-parent with the mother of his children, and that really at the end of the day, that's what's important here, are our kids. So I'm gonna leave this video here, and I love you guys. Thank you.